The government of Uganda started the resettlement of landslide-affected people in Bududa, Sironko, Manafwa, Namisindwa, and Bulambuli districts in 2019. And so far, about 300 families with over 5,000 people have benefited from the scheme of one plot of land plus another 2 acres for cultivation. The resettlement started with 10 families consisting of 60 people and were brought to Bunambutie area in Bulambuli district in the first phase, which was led by the Office of the Prime Minister of Uganda. And they are currently in the fourth phase. Much as people are appreciating the government for relocating them to safer places, they claim the government has not done enough to provide social services to them. They lack clean water sources, schools for their children, among other services.
Eddagala tufuna just bwebanga emuyembe teriliyo nafe waffe teriberayo
amazi ketufuna olumu tekabaawo n'amasanyalazi tufuna wekali amasanyalazi wekali naye sibo
ogoba ku ssomero obeera nga oli kadongo kamu nga tolina gyojja ssente bw'obeera nga togenza okukola kibalo tosobola afuna ssente okulya emmere kizibu kati ng'akasana wekaliwo tewali n'emmere.
This was during a site visit to Bulambutie by the UPDF's engineering brigade, which was contracted to construct a house where mudslide-affected families were relocated. Engineer Major Chizito Mulwana, the site engineer, explained that in phase four of the project, they managed to construct 42 housing units, each costing 50 million shillings.
Challenge here is weather. From the time we started, it never rained even a single day. Meaning that when, and you know, construction, almost everything that goes with water, meaning that we watered from the day we started up to the final day when we handed over. And when the rain comes, there is nothing that any work that you can do. The soil is too sticky. The types of soil here are cotton soils. So when it rains, it's always a disaster. When it's in sunshine, it's always a disaster.
You inspect from another perspective. For us, we are an internal mechanism to ensure our engineers now who have an extra role to build for others, because previously they were building for us only. They do a good work, they follow government procedures.
Meanwhile, the chief administrative officer, Abieto Stiller, praised the work of the Ugandan government and the UPDF Engineers Brigade, but urged for more houses to be built for further evacuation of people from the landslide-affected areas, as there are still many in the disaster-prone area, yet the rains are on.
It's been rare, but I want to appreciate UPDF because we deal with them like any other Ugandans that we have. When they are stuck, for example, the water problem that was mentioned by the engineer, we gave them the district water bowser because it is serving in Bulambuli. So they were using our water bowser to transport water and help them in the construction. We want to appreciate this number that has helped settle more people. But we want to inform government and the army that we still have very many people who are in risky areas that need to be settled. If only government would take up and request UPDF again to construct more units, it would be helped to decongest. Our fear was the rains are beginning. We might get mudslides again.
The construction of 101 houses in the first phase was entrusted to the UPDF Engineering Brigade and started on the 5th of December 2018 to 2019 March. And there were different phases, and now phase 4 has 305 houses, with 42 houses first built. According to the resettlement scheme on the 2,800 acres of land that was acquired by the government of Uganda in 2013, 250 houses will be built on plot 94, which measures 270 acres of land. Plot 157, which is 918 acres, will house 650 houses. But plot 198, with 1,688 acres of land, will be for cultivation. Report by Rachel Natuwala for the news.